Welcome back to the SQUADCAST, where we're giving you all of our feels on the best of gaming in 2020. Malik and Steve gave us their insights, and I'm supposed to go next, but you know what? I'm going to actually throw it to Caboose because I'm polite like that. So.
How nice.
How kind of you. Okay.
Oh, or boy. If you want, go. It doesn't games. Matter. Yeah.
No, I got this. I got this, okay. I think. Top three games. I mean, as a surprise to no one, of course, I would put Ghost of Tsushima up there. That game came out of nowhere for me. I've said it multiple times in that it wasn't a game I was like looking forward to actively. You know, I was like, oh, that looks cool. I'll probably play it eventually. And then because I was streaming and didn't really have anything to stream, I was like, you know what? I'm just going to play this. Screw it. Why not? And then next thing you know, 2-3 hours in, I was like, wait, hold on. And then 20 or so hours later, I beat the game and I'm like, this is the best game of the console generation. It really, truly blew me away from a story standpoint, definitely from a gameplay standpoint, and then especially from a visual standpoint. Mm-hmm. It is the prettiest game to look at out of every PlayStation exclusive. And I don't think that is a statement that is very, like, there's not much of an argument to be had there. There's some pretty looking PlayStation exclusives, you know, Spider-Man, Miles Morales, or Spider-Man PS4, God of War, Last of Us, Last of Us 2. But I think that everyone is probably in unanimous agreement in that Ghost of Tsushima is the most visually pleasing game to look at. And then as well, then a couple months later, out of nowhere, they're like, hey, by the way, you can play this with your friends. You like all the gameplay that you got? You want to play an RPG straight up with Ghost of Tsushima's combat? Here you go. And I didn't play it for a little bit at first. I got late on that too. But once I started playing it, I was hooked all over again. Got super into the way that they structured the multiplayer. Was super excited for the raids. I still haven't done the full raid, but I did part one of the raid, and I remember enjoying the hell out of it. I just got to find the time to do the yeah, I got to do the other two parts. I want to get the gear, too. That's another thing that I love about Ghost of Tsushima is the customization. Like, oh, my God. That style, that era, and the way that, you know, these samurais, the way that they looked, the way that their armor was back in the day. Like, oh, man. Just so cool. It's just so cool. And then I had like a Kurosawa mode where you could like straight up put this filter on the game where it was like one of his films. Like that game has blown me away top to bottom. And it's one of these games where I will remember it forever.
Yeah.
And so that's absolutely one of my three. Spider-Man Miles Morales, of course, another one. I'm a huge fan of Marvel. I'm a huge fan of that world. I was really excited that they set up the character in Spider-Man PS4, but I was truly not expecting that he was going to get his own game. I was expecting that we were going to get a Spider-Man 2, and he was sort of going to be like he was going to become Spider-Man throughout that. But lo and behold, Insomniac's like, no, we want to take our time with this. We want to make sure that this character is well developed, has his own story to be told. And I really enjoyed the hell out of that game. It was and it was a shorter game too. And I remember we talked about this too, about the fact that is like, do we want games that kind of overstay their welcome, or are we cool with games sometimes just being like a fun little 6-7 hour easy to digest experience? And I think that's exactly what Spider-Man Miles Morales is, except it leaves a very lasting impact. It's one of these 6-7 hour games where, you know, maybe if it went on to like 15-20, it could have like some filler moments, but because it's just that quick get in, play the story, get out, you have like those small little subtle moments that really leave impact on you as a player. And so that game, I love it. Plus like all the upgrades to the swinging, the gameplay, the air tricks, the photo mode, like that stuff, I love it. I love it. Give me more of that. I hope that in Spider-Man 2, they find a way to get Peter to be doing some cool air tricks as well, because that was just like, it's therapeutic for me sometimes. Sure. I'll sit down for an hour and just play Spider-Man Miles Morales, either whether like trying to make new photos or whatever it might be. And I could just swing around the city forever and just have like just so much fun with it. So that's definitely on the top three. And I really had to think about it because, like, part of me wants to pick something like Warzone because of how many hours I put into something like Warzone. But I guess I would want to think of, like, another story experience that I really sunk my teeth into. And that was probably The Last of Us Part Two. And although I don't necessarily think the game is a masterpiece, and I have some grievances with some of the ways, like, just some story beats. And it's not the one, like, it's not the ones that everyone usually points out. I have some issues with the game. It's not a 10 out of 10 for me. But again, similar to the first game, it was one of those games where it felt real. The characters were real. The emotion was there. It made me cry in several moments. I was captivated. Regardless of, even though, like, I had issues with the game, I was captivated. And they had me for every second of it. Kudos to Naughty Dog for what they did with The Last of Us Part Two. Now I look forward to seeing what they're going to do with their multiplayer mode.
Yeah.
True.
It'll be great to see that return of, that multiplayer. Whenever, like, I feel like it's hard for story-based games to come out with modes way after release. Because a lot of people buy into their games or want to play because of that story. And that's especially the case for The Last of Us Part Two. Yeah. Would I return to The Last of Us Part Two for the multiplayer? Maybe to test it out. But I don't know if that would keep me there.
Fair.
Yeah. You know what I mean?
That's fair. Yeah.
I think going forward, Ghost of Tsushima has kind of set this precedent of, like, what is possible. They've made it very clear that the multiplayer was a main component of the game from the start. They just left it out and nobody knew about it. So I think if games have a multiplayer portion in mind from the inception and the beginning of development, then I think it can work, but just adding it on, I'm worried it might dilute the quality of the game.
Yeah, I think it also has to do with, like, who's making the multiplayer game, because, like, Naughty Dog is known, obviously, for their very compelling single-player narrative-focused games. They're not exactly known for their multiplayer game. Sure, Uncharted had it, Last of Us had it. I enjoyed the Last of Us multiplayer quite a bit, but again, I'm not buying into the Last of Us or an Uncharted game for its multiplayer. I'm there for the characters and the story. That always comes secondary, and, like, Camille, like, yeah, sure, I'll try it out, but am I going to be playing that over Warzone or Fortnite or, like, those mainstays in the multiplayer space? Who knows, but I think that they have a slightly less chance of becoming an everyday multiplayer game.
Now, Caboose, you mentioned earlier that DC fandom was, like, one of your most memorable events. I know you sprinkled some other things in there. Is there anything else you want to add that really stood out for you in terms of, like, your favorite gaming moment outside of your favorite games? Or even inside your favorite games, maybe a reveal?
I'm trying to think what that would be for me, because, like, DC fandom is probably just the tippy top of that. But even, like, I guess more recently, seeing Back 4 Blood get revealed. I'm a huge Left 4 Dead fan. Like, Left 4 Dead, way back in the day, was one of the first kind of, like, multiplayer games I got into. I used to play that game like crazy. And it actually came to the point where me and a friend, we decided, you know, let's try it out again. And this was before Back 4 Blood was revealed. We've known about Back 4 Blood for a long time.
Yeah.
You know, they, like, the Turtle Rock had announced it a very long time ago. We just haven't seen it. But we knew, like, we were essentially getting another Left 4 Dead game. And so me and a friend were like, yo, let's just try out Left 4 Dead 2 again, see what's going on there, because they added the that new update. They added the new content to the game. And then we sort of, like, came up with this, our Left 4 Dead esports, if you will, where we got eight people together. So it was a full lobby, four people, like, and we would organize it so that there are two team captains who pick the teams. Whoever gets first pick, the opposite team gets to choose their side. So if they want to be infected or survivors first.
Yeah.
And we, like, the way we would do it is we would have all eight people in the same call, making callouts, talking trash. It was like Gears of War the way we were doing it. and I remember just like, that was such a fun experience for me. And then finally, like, here I am at the Game Awards and I see Back 4 Blood get revealed, and having, like, you know, known about the game for so long, it was really exciting for me to see, like, essentially a brand new Left 4 Dead game. And then a week later, we got to play it, and I enjoyed it. I'm looking forward to Back 4 Blood. I just wish we could have gotten a taste of the PvP, but I know it's still so far away, so we got to wait. But yeah, I'm very excited for Back 4 Blood, and I'm very excited to get that same group of 8 people together for that game and do our Back 4 Blood esports, if you will.
That should be
a lot of fun. Yeah,
it looks much better than I thought it was going to.
Yes,
because when I saw the trailer, I was thinking, there's no way it's going to look like this. There's no way. This is just, you know, the done up version. But watching streamers play it, it looks incredible, and I love the more realistic style, you know, of the weapons, and it looks like they put a lot of care into the fine details.
Yeah, it actually feels like a really good FPS. Weirdly enough, and not to knock, I don't want to like create a controversy here. Feels like a better FPS than Cyberpunk does, if I'm being honest.
Oh, really?
It feels way more smooth, like, mechanically.
I thought Cyberpunk, like, actually pretty smooth. Like, even when you're trying to cover behind pillars, like, I actually like that movement.
I don't know. Have you played? Are you playing on PC or console?
I'm playing console.
Okay. I don't know. For me, it just feels like clunky. It feels like I'm always playing on input delay when I play Cyberpunk.
It feels so sluggish to me anyways.
Yeah. But yeah, like I was really, really impressed with Back 4 Blood. The only, like, I have some concern, or not concerns, but like feedback to provide. And then I think the difficulty needs some tuning. If you're playing on not the easiest difficulty, it is the hardest difficulty. and as well, like, I guess I want it to be a little more Left 4 Dead than less. I know they can essentially copy and paste Left 4 Dead and put that into this game.
Right? Like, just do it.
I agree. I think just like the simplicity of Left 4 Dead is what made it so good. But I do like the system of the decks and the perks that you can get at the start of each game. I think that's pretty interesting. But I think one of the main issues that I had, and maybe this won't even apply for the PvP, so I have nothing to worry about. But one of the main issues that I had is, if you're not playing on the easiest difficulty and you like lose all your health, essentially, you don't get knocked down and can get revived, you die. And then you have to be like saved later on in the level, or your teammates just have to go into the safe room. I don't like that. I want always for there to be like the second chance, you know?
Yeah.
I think that it's lame if, like, you know, you get swarmed by a horde and there's literally nothing you can do and that's the end of the game for you, you know? Mm-hmm. So I hope that some mechanics like that get changed. And I just can't wait to see what the PvP is going to be like, because that's the most exciting aspect of the game for me. But yeah, when that game was revealed during the Game Awards, kind of came out of nowhere, and getting to play it a week later was really exciting.